वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द कंजेनाइटल मालफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग कंजेनाइटल मालफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द वजाइना. हियर वी स्टार्ट विद द कंजेनाइटल मालफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द वल्वास. सो अंडर द मालफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द वल्वा देयर आर मेनली टू कंडीशंस, दैट इज अ लेबिया हाइपोप्लेशिया एंड सेकेंड वन इज द लेबियल hypertrophy. Okay, hypo that is decrease developments, and hyper that is excessive or more than normal growth and development is there. So first, that is a labial hypoplasia. A labial hypoplasia, it occurs when one or both of the labia, they do not develop normally. Okay, there are two labias, that is labia minora and majora. So they do not develop properly or normally. The labia act as a fat pads, and that is protect from the trauma. And this irregularity, it can surface either during the childhood or throughout the puberty. Means the doctors, or we can notify this during the childhood development or during the puberty. So that is a hypoplasia, that is abnormal developments of that is decreased developments of the labia. Second one, hypertrophy. A labial hypertrophy describes the enlargements of the labia, means the labia that are very larger or enlarged than the normal size. This can lead to irritation, chronic infections, interference with the intercourse, and the feeling of pain at the time of the intercourse. So labial hypertrophy, there is enlargements of the labia, and due to the enlargement there are chances of the irritation, infection, interference with the intercourse, and pain during the intercourse. So these are two abnormalities of the vulva, hypoplasia and hypertrophy. Next, congenital anomalies of the hymen. Okay, hymen, that is a covering, or there is a one layer of the female reproductive that is covering the vaginal opening. Okay, so first, that is imperforate hymen. Okay, so imperforate hymen, in simple meanings, that is a the hymen which is without any obstruction, or that is a fully covering the vagina. So due to that imperforate hymen, there is a one of the congenital disorders where hymen that is without an opening completely obstruct the vagina. Means this imperforate hymen, it will obstruct the pathway of the vagina, and it is caused by a failure of the hymen to perforate during the fetal development. It most often diagnosed in the adolescent girls when they are having a menstruation, and because of the imperforate hymen, the menstrual blood that does not come out, and that is accumulated inside the vagina. And sometimes if excessive blood is there, then it is goes to a uterus, but it is not coming out. So that is imperforate hymen. So imperforate hymen, that is a opening without opening, and it is obstructing the vagina. This is, can see that here the menstrual blood has been collected, and it can be accumulated inside the vagina and in the uterus, but now is not coming out because here there is no any opening. Symptoms of imperforate hymen. The symptoms include mass or fullness in the lower parts of the vagina. Means there is feeling that some mass is there, or the lower parts of the belly is very full due to the accumulation of the menstrual blood from the buildup of the blood that can't come out. Second symptoms, that is a pain in the stomach, back pain, and problems with urination and bowel movements. Means urinary and bowel movements will be altered. So these are the basic symptoms: feeling of mass or fullness, pain in the stomach, back, and problems with urination and the bowel. Next is the treatment of imperforate hymen. A minor surgery, it can fix an imperforate hymen. Means a minor surgery can relieve the symptoms of imperforate hymen. Under that, the surgeon, they makes a small cut or incision. Means a very small cut or very small incision is made up over the imperforate hymen layer, and it removes extra hymen membranes. So there is a removal of this hymen membrane. Girls who are diagnosed with the imperforate hymen as babies, they most often have surgery when they are older and have just started the puberty. Means those who have history, or there is those who have confirmed the diagnosis of imperforate hymen, they can surgery at the time of the puberty. The surgery is done in early puberty when there are symptoms of secondary sexual characteristic, that is developments of the breast, developments of the pubic hair has begun. But girls who are diagnosed when they are older have the same surgery. The surgery allows treated menstrual blood to leave the body. Means after the incision, the accumulated blood can be removed. The girls, they can recover from the surgery in a very few days. After the surgery, the girls may have to insert a dilator into the vagina for 15 minutes each day. Means the dilator will help to keep the opening fully open, that relieves the obstruction and does not reoccur the condition of imperforate hymen. A dilator that looks like a tampon, this keeps the incision from closing on itself and keeps the vagina opening. So that's a treatment. A very small surgery, small cut and incision can relieve the condition of imperforate hymen. The babies who have diagnosed earlier, they can surgery at the time of the puberty, and after the puberty they can recover in few days. But there is a need to insert a dilator for 15 minutes each day, because the dilator keeps the incision from closing on itself and keeps the vagina open. That's a treatment of imperforate hymen. Second, there is a microperforate hymen. Micro means very small. So a microperforate hymen is similar to an imperforate hymen, but with the presence of very small hole within it. In imperforate, there was no hole, but in the microperforate, there was a very small hole within the layer. This hole makes it difficult for blood and mucus to come through the hymenal opening. The hole is very small that the blood and mucus, they cannot come out. Instead of regular period, they are lasting 4 to 7 days. The girls could experience a longer period due to the fact that the blood cannot drain at a normal rate. The normal menstrual period, that is a 5 to 7 days, but the girls with the microperforate hymen, they can experience a very longer duration of menstrual cycle, because the blood that cannot come out at the normal rate, so it takes a longer duration to come. This can also make wearing tampons painful. A hymenal tissue could tear during the intercourse. So the tissues can tear at the time of the intercourse. A microperforate hymen could go away as the age increases, or it could tear away due to the tampons or due to the intercourse. Surgical correction can be perforated to remove the extra tissues and creation of the normal opening. Here you can see that this is only a very small hole, that is a microperforate hymen. Okay, so with the microperforate hymen, only a small amount of bleeding can be come. So the girls can have a longer menstrual periods. Next is a septate hymen. Septate means there are two division or one section has been developed. A septate hymen is when the hymenal membrane has extra tissues in the middle and they are causing two small vaginal opening as opposed to one. Means due to the septate hymen, means once extra tissues are there in the middle and due to that two small vaginal openings are there. This could interfere with the ability to wear a tampon or to take a tampon after it has filled with the bloods. A septate hymen does not need to be surgically removed and it is typically torn during the sexual intercourse. The possible side effects that includes pain, discomforts or chances of the bleeding. This can be corrected via a very simple surgical approach and that removes a septate hymen. So under the condition of the septate hymen, there is one extra tissue layer is there, so two separate opening of the vagina is there and there are difficulties in removal of the tampons. Okay. The septate hymens, you can see that these two openings are there due to the extra tissues of the hymen. Okay, so that's about the congenital anomalies of the vulva and the hymen. Under the vulva, two conditions we have seen, that is labial hypoplasia and hypertrophy. Hypoplasia not normally developed, hyper enlargements of the hymens, in that imperforate hymen, that is the hymen that is without opening, and accumulation of the menstrual blood inside the vagina and inside the uterus. This is a diagram of the imperforate hymen. Second symptoms, mass or fullness, pain in the stomach and back, and problems with urination and bowels. Treatment, that is a minor small cut or incision, and need of the dilators for 15 minutes each day. Microperforate means very small incision is there, so the girls will experience a longer menstrual period than the normal. Here is a diagram, that is a microperforate hymen is. Next is a septate hymen, means because of the extra tissues layer, there are two vaginal openings and difficulties in the removal of the tampons. This is a diagram of the septate hymen, under that two openings we can see. Next is the congenital anomalies of the vagina. So under the vagina, there is congenital anomalies in that first, that is a transverse vaginal septum. Okay. Septum, that we know that there is a one or divisional section or extra tissues, they are dividing any structure, that is known as the septum. So a transverse vaginal septum, it is a horizontal collection of the tissues that are formed in the time of the embryonic development. It essentially creates a blockage of the vagina. This can occur at different levels of the vagina. Some women, they have a small hole in the septum that is called a fenestration. And during the menstrual period, the blood could take longer to flow, causing the period to last longer than 4 to 7 days. And if there is no hole and the septum is blocking the upper vagina from the lower, then the menstrual blood can pull out and that is accumulated and it can cause the abdominal pain. And this will most likely require a surgical correction of the septum vagina. So transverse vaginal septum, that is a horizontally collection of the tissues at the time of embryological developments. There is a blockage of the vagina. If there is a small hole, then that is called the fenestration. And due to the blockage, the menstrual blood flow cannot come out, the periods will go longer, and there are chances of the lower vaginal or abdominal pain. This is a diagram of the transverse septum. Here you can see that this is a septum has been developed, so the opening is completely closed. Here you can see the diagram of the longitudinal septum. Okay. So due to that, the opening is also closed. Next, vertical or complete vaginal septum. It is a condition where a wall of tissue, they run vertically up and down length of the vagina, and that are dividing into two cavities. While this condition may cause no any symptoms, the women, they can experience pain when removing or inserting a tampon, or pain at the time of the intercourse. So vertical or complete septum, in that there are up and down the length of the vagina runs, and there are two cavities will be developed. There are no other symptoms other than removal and insertion of tampon will be difficult or pain at the time of the intercourse. Next is the agenesis. Agenesis means absence. Okay? And vaginal agenesis means the absence of the vagina. The vaginal agenesis is a condition that develops before birth, where the vagina it fails to fully develop. Okay, so vaginal agenesis, in that the vagina will not able to develop, and the most common form of this condition, that is known as Meyerhold Rakitansky Koester Hoster's syndrome, that is MRKH syndrome, in which the vagina it does not develop in the embryo. Women with MRKH, they have functional ovaries, means the two pairs of ovary will be there, and there are several variations of MRKH syndrome, such as the lack of vagina and the uterus, sometimes no vagina but a single midline uterus and no cervix will be there. The symptoms, they include small pouch where the vagina should be, means there are a small pouch like structure has been developed instead of the vagina, and there is absence of the menstrual cycle and feeling of lower abdominal pain. The vaginal agenesis requires surgical correction, or having a sexual intercourse and a baby may be impossible. And some women may have some kidney abnormalities in association with the vaginal agenesis. Okay? So vaginal agenesis, that is a completely absence of the vagina, and that is known as MRKH syndrome, Meyerhold Rakitansky Koester Hoster syndrome. There are different types or several variations, such as in that one, there is a lack of vagina and the uterus, and there is no vagina, and single midline uterus or no cervix will be there. So that is about the abnormalities of the vagina.